The heavens call, the earth cries out, the crowds roar, all calling on me to strike back against evil. Now listen up, villains! I'm the warrior of justice, Michael!
If you somehow didn't catch all of that, it's me again, Michael, with the newest Writer Rewind episode. The show where we take a look at writer drivers, henshin devices, and figures that were announced in the last 2 to 3 weeks. It's what I would say, usually. This one's a bit later, but to make up for it, it's much bigger too. Let's get right into it, shall we? Now, the stronger opening may have made you think I'd be talking about Stronger today, but no such luck, I'm afraid. Instead, we'll be talking about the SH Figuar Shinkocho Seiho Kamen Rider V3, the Kamen Rider born from the combined powers of Ichigo and Nigo, who then, not long after creating V3, got blasted into oblivion by a giant turtle with a bazooka strapped to its back. Anyways, he's about 145mm tall and comes with 2 cloth mufflers so that you can pose him in whatever dynamic pose your heart desires. Not only that, but he gets a V3 hopper accessory, spare antennae, and a set of interchangeable hands, so you can replicate all of those crazy hand motions the Showa writers do. Next up, we've got the SH Figuarts Kamen Rider Aguilera from Kamen Rider Revice. Another writer from that show to have gotten an SHF before even the main side writer got one. She's about 145mm tall and uses, I'm only reading what's written here, right? Specific joint placements to achieve feminine proportions and strike powerful poses. Stay classy, Japan. She comes with her needle kunai and a set of interchangeable hands. As a little extra, she comes with the Kamakiri V-stamp for SH Figuarts Revy and Vice. Ain't that neat? Continuing with Revice, we have the 50 Gale V-Stamp, another masterclass in rider item naming from the folks over at Toei. It's used by the Igarashi siblings to transform into Kamen Rider Igarashi. Here's how to do that. You press the button on the top of the stamp, making the fan rotate, and stamp it down into the driver. Slot it into the driver, pull the V-Stamp. Ta-da! You've become Kamen Rider Igarashi. A rider I know absolutely nothing about since I haven't seen the movie yet, so no snarky remarks this time. Oh, right. And if you pull the V-Stamp again, you activate the finisher. It also comes with voice lines from Ikki, Daiji, and Sakura. Stay on the topic of V-Stamps, we have the DX V-Stamp Selection 4, which features 4 new V-Stamps. We have Kamen Rider Blade for the King Crab V-Stamp, Kamen Rider Kabuto for the Omukade V-Stamp, Kamen Rider Ghost for the Kudosai V-Stamp, and my personal favorite rider of all time, Kamen Rider Drive for the Octopus V-Stamp. Absolutely none of these riders fit those animals. These V-Stamps can be used with any V-Stamp compatible driver, and also non-V-Stamp compatible drivers. You just gotta try really hard. Speaking of V-Stamp compatible drivers, we have the DX Chimera Driver and Juga Driver unit. This driver is used to transform into Kamen Rider Chimera, Kamen Rider Daimon, and Kamen Rider Juga. To transform into Chimera, you press the top of the Twin Chimera V-Stamp, slam it down into the driver, and pull the V-Stamp, resulting in you becoming Chimera and having his idle loop stuck in your head. You're welcome. If you want to become Daimon, you simply slap the Tri-Chimera faceplate onto the stamp, creating the Tri-Chimera V-Stamp. Then do the exact same as you did for Chimera, and you'll transform into Daimon. Now to become Juga, you first gotta pop the Juga driver unit onto the driver, then press the top of the Juga V-Stamp, and slap it down onto the driver. Give it a good pull, and you become Kuai-Bin Juga. Yeah, Juga. That's what I meant to say. Juga's V-Stamp also comes with voice lines from George himself, so you can listen to him freak out whenever your heart desires. And now, finally, we get to what I desire. The DX Desire Driver from the upcoming show Kamen Rider Geats. This is the driver used by the riders in the show to turn into respective riders. But this set specifically comes with the MC Geats, so how do you become him? Well, you simply insert the Rider Core ID in the middle of the driver and become Geats Entry Form. But that's not all. Since this set comes with 3, count them 3, raise buckles, you can turn it into plenty of forms. Let me tell you about them. By slapping the Magnum raise buckle into the right half of the driver, you become Geats Magnum Form. Then, by slapping the Boost raise buckle into the left half of the driver, you become Geats Magnum Boost. But wait, there's more. You can make the driver spin around and thusly become Geats Boost Magnum. And then that's not even talking about the Hammer raise buckle that's included. In total, you can turn into 10 forms, which is just insane. this, in my opinion, is one of the coolest drivers ever. I love the more toned-down all-business announcer like we had in Heisei Phase 1, combined with the more over-the-top interactivity of the later drivers. Absolutely wonderful stuff. Very excited to see the upgrade form buckles and how they interact with the driver. Can't have a main rider release without something from the side rider, now can you? So here we've got the DX Zombie Race Buckle and Race Buckle Holder set. It comes with Kamen Rider Buffa's ID core, the Zombie Buckle, and two buckle holders. Because you just can't have Modern Rider without gimmick holders on the belt. Here's how to become Kamen Rider Buffa. First, you insert the ID core into the center of the driver, becoming Buffa entry form. Then you slap the Zombie Race Buckle into the right half of the driver, twist the lever-looking thing on the front of the race buckle, and become Kamen Rider Buffa Zombie form. Not much else I can say here since the show hasn't released yet, so let's move on, shall we? And with move on, I mean go even deeper into Geats, with the DX-01 Driver Race Buckle. Take the race buckle, slap it onto the right side of the driver, and become Geats-01. Or at least, I think that's what it's called? Also, I have absolutely no clue what this form looks like. But, while I was writing this episode, they showed how the Revice form looks like. So I guess it's gonna be something like that. Kinda scary looking with that Revice grin, isn't he? While we might not know what the 01 form looks like, we at least know what these two look like. The DX Shield and Arrow Race Buckles. I set out to use these so many times in this episode that I'm not even gonna bother. You know the drill by now, and if you don't, just like, go back by a minute. Also, can we talk about these quote-unquote forms for a bit? Seems they're all repaints. Honestly, I don't mind, because it's confirmed that there's a loot system of sorts to raise buckles, so these are low-power ones. But still, I'd be lying if I said that seeing all these repaints immediately show up after Saban and Revice didn't make me worry a bit. I suppose we'll see once Geats drops. You know what isn't a repaint? Geats' badass Magnum Shooter 40X. A goofy but cool name for a goofy but cool gun. Here's what you can do with it. It shoots. I'm kidding. It does a few more things than just shoot. You can flip open the barrel to have it switch between handgun and rifle mode like it does in the show. Allegedly. You can pull back on the tail-like bit sticking out on the back to activate the bullet charge. This can be done in both handgun and rifle modes. This gun also comes with the water race buckle that you can slap onto the front of the gun to activate a special move. This works with any race buckle. Lastly, you can put this gun onto the buckle holders that came with the Buffa set. Alright, that's enough Geats for now. Let's move on to Double, shall we? Well, Futo Tante to be precise. And yes, I know it's actually called Futo PI and not Tante, but that sounds weird to say, so Tante it is. Not that any of it matters, because we're here for the SH Figuar Chinko Shoseiho Kamen Rider Double Heat Metal Futo Tante Anime Memorial Edition. Whew, that was a mouthful, but basically, it's the Chinko Shoseiho Double Heat Metal with colors that simulate those from the Futo Tante anime. It comes with a special base, the metal shaft, yes that's actually what it's called, I can't believe it either, flame effects for the metal branding finisher, and a Futo Tante anime on BD, specifically episodes 7 to 12. Oh, and don't worry, it comes with the usual set of interchangeable hands. And for those who aren't big Heat Metal fans, there's also Luna Trigger version that also comes with the main weapon, effects for the finisher, and the anime on BD with the same episodes. Also, I feel I should mention that the anime episodes will more than likely not come with English subs, so just be aware of that when you get them, alright? Still on the double train, we have the CSM Double Driver for 1.5 Futo Tante Edition. Here's what's different from the OG 1.5 CSM. It's painted slightly different, the memories come with holographic stickers, and the memories come with voice lines from the anime's VA. And yeah, that's about it. A good chance to get a CSM if you couldn't before, but only if you like the anime's VAs. Personally, I like them, but I got used to them before the anime since they also voiced Shotaro and Philip in the fun but buggy Memory of Heroes video game. And with that, we finally come to the end of this Rider Rewind. God, that was a long one. Not only that, but a slew of announcements were made while I was writing this one, so I guess I'd better start working on those too, huh? Oh great Obazio in the sky, please have mercy on me. If anything you saw here today made you want to spend some of that cold, hard-earned cash, then be sure to do it at the Toku Toy Store, your one-stop shop for any and all Toku merch. Oh, yeah, and if you think I'm wrong about everything ever, be sure to tell me that on my Twitter. And maybe also give me a follow. Not even my employer does that. Why must you hate me so, Toku Toy Store? Alright, enough for me. I'm out. See ya!
get much higher, higher.
So high.